Hello guys, welcome back to Appsheet tutorial. This is Aditya. I have 3 years of experience in Appsheet and I'm entrepreneur. So thank you guys, we have reached more than 1k subscribers. Thank you all for your support. And in today's video, we're going to see about how to import transactions report in Appsheet. So basically every business have their own transactions and they are using their own system or Excel sheet or something. So in that we're going to import into our AppSheet app, and in the later part we can see how to send those invoices to the customer as a tax invoice, and then we are going to store it in our Google Drive. So we'll split it into 3 parts of this video. So for this video I just use my own business transaction report as an example demo. So I'm going to download yesterday's transaction report and we're going to import into our AppSheet app, and then we're going to send those tax invoice to the customers, as well as we're going to store it in our Google Drive for our future filings or tax filing any purpose. So this is a very helpful tool we can use in our tax filings for all businesses. So I'm just giving a demo. So this is our business and we're going to download our yesterday's transaction report. So we are using Razorpay as a payment gateway here. Recent reports. So yesterday's transaction report I have downloaded in CSV format. So while importing into AppSheet, the main important thing is the column names. So I have downloaded just a moment. So this is the transaction report of yesterday. So for our demo, I'm just going to use any 4 or 5 transactions. Everything I'm going to others I'm going to delete it. So while importing, the column name should be same as we're going to create in the AppSheet also, then only it will get imported according to that columns. Okay, so this is a yesterday's transaction report. I'm just going to import the email and the amount and description. Okay, so only 3 parameters I'm going to import. This email, amount and description is the amount, email this description, okay, for generating the invoice. So these 3 and invoice number also we can import, because invoice number should be the key column. I'll explain that while doing an AppSheet. So these 3 parameters we're going to import to our AppSheet app. So I'm just creating a new app for this. And drive also, I'll just create a new spreadsheet. Voices. So main thing we have to mention the key column, that is invoice number, let me as key column, and these 3 parameters, amount, description and email. Okay, so email can go, and the same copy you should have to, so just copy the same name from the report, then only it will works properly. Email, description and amount. So this invoice number also we can fill from here itself. So instead of ID, I'm going to change this to invoice number, because this will be the key column. For tax invoices or any billing purpose, this invoice number should be unique and properly formatted. So I'm just going to give today's date. So today's date 7/ So today's date and this number is just 1, 2, 3, 4, the sequence, today's number of billing sequence. Okay, I'm just saving this. is also. Now we have created this four columns. Okay. Now in this app, I'm just going to use this data invoices. So if you see here, so this is the invoice number which we have imported in this invoices sheet which I created. There's all four parameters I'm going to import, and I have created a new app with this invoice data. And then so if you go to the data and columns, check once, invoice number is key and email description amount and everything is here. Okay, so email description number, so amount you can change it to price. I'm just using INR, say Indian rupee, I'm just using, and then save. So now we're going to create a new action button to import data. So go to behavior, a new action, just import action name, and do this will be import a CSV file for this view. Okay, so local will be English. And appearance wise, we can give import icon. And I'm saving it. So here, okay. So this display should be overlay. You can keep, okay, so that you can see here the input. Now you see there is no data from this invoices sheet. So now I'm going to import the yesterday's transaction. Okay, so this one payment 6. It's not saved yet. There is some error in the key, so I'll just save. Okay, it's not get saved properly. Import test. Okay, I see it. Now again I'm just importing the same import test. So having key into the invoices for this checkpoint. And just check there is some error in that invoice number. Okay, invoice number is perfectly matched. Same. I'm just copy pasting this thing. Let's import again. Yeah, now it's working. There is some issue in spacing issue in this invoice number. So I just try to copy paste all the header columns by importing. So see, now we have imported successfully the respective amount column and descriptions came here. Okay. So make sure the key column is properly copy pasted. So in this way, we can import our data power from other transactions report. And in the next video, we can see how we're going to send the tax invoice to this particular email. And the later part, we can see we can store all those invoices in a single Google Drive folder for future accounting purposes. So thank you guys. We'll see in the next video. If you like this video, just like and share and give a comment if you have any doubts. Yes. Thank you.